X-ray position using these site pattern probabilities that Laura just talked about before taxa on a model that has both incomplete lineage sorting and then also high precision. So if you're familiar with sort of the D-statistic or these ABBA-BABBA style tests, it's very similar to that, except it uses a couple other of the site pattern probabilities. So you can think about it as there's an outgroup sequence, a hybrid, and then the hybrid's two parents, and the species network is basically a combination of the two different species trees that can make up that network, where the hybrid is either with parent two, and it shares gamma percent of its genome with the parent two, or it's paired with the first parent, and one minus gamma percent of its genome is from that parent. And the hypothesis test that we actually conduct is whether or not gamma is equal to zero, or if it's greater than zero, so if there's hybridization or not. So the software that we've actually written to do this hypothesis test has two major pieces to it. So the first one we've called FIDE. This sort of provides a Pythonic interface for doing these hypothesis tests, and also there was already a Python package called Hide, so we could use that. So got super creative and added a P in front of it. And then there's a C++ program as well that sort of operates behind the scenes that is more of the workhorse to do things faster, and also if you have, say, more than four species or something and you want to do a lot of these tests, it will go through and iterate through every single one for you. Another thing that we did was, because Python can be kind of slow sometimes, we coded up the computationally intensive parts of these tests using something called Cython, which basically lets you use C and C++ style things in Python. And then the input is basically just an alignment of DNA sequences in sequential file format, and then a time-limited text file that has all of your individuals that you've sampled, and then the taxa that you map to. So the sort of philosophy behind Hide is that this is probably just a bunch of gibberish computer code, but the idea is that your analyses can be written as Python scripts. And so you can sort of control what you do in terms of what hypotheses you test, and also what you do with that output. But at the same time, you've also tried to sort of expose these other functions that will basically do everything for you without having to think about it. But the other idea is that you can use these Jupyter notebooks to sort of have your entire analysis from start to finish all curated and whatever figures or whatever else you want to include. Okay, so the main features are basically just some Python classes to work with it. The data itself resides from results from the C++ program, and then also we've implemented some bootstrapping stuff, so working with the bootstrap advocates. And the other thing that we've added from sort of previous versions of the software, if you've worked with that, is analysis can now be done at the population level, so you can include multiple individuals per population. And what I wanted to do next was just kind of walk through a couple of the main features, two of the main functions for doing stuff with the program. So test triple is the main function for doing any hypothesis test, and then run hide is sort of the function that will do everything for you. So it basically takes three lines of code in Python to do any analysis. So you import the module, read in the data, and then do that hypothesis test. And what gets spit out back to you is, so for this res variable, it's a Python dictionary that has the test statistic, the p-value for the test, and then the estimate of gamma, so how much hybridization is coming from the second parent. And for this run-hide method, basically what it does is it calls the C++ program, and will go and do every single test for you. I'm running a little bit out of time, but you can do other things like have bootstrap, and it will all be run into Python, and so dictionaries that you can do whatever you want with. One of the things that we've also tried to add is to have some plotting. So we have some basic functions where you can look at the distribution of the different things that are calculated by Hive. So if you're interested in using the software, it's on GitHub. We've also put the build package on the Python package index. We're working on some documentation and tutorial as well. So thank you very much, and thanks to Cecilia.